In this lesson, you will learn about function procedures. There are many similarities between sub and function procedures. Both are used in modular programming to divide code into more manageable pieces. Both can be used multiple times in a program. Both communicate with other procedures using arguments. Arguments can be passed by reference or passed by value to both types of procedures, and variables are locally defined by default in both types of procedures. There are two main differences between sub and function procedures. First, sub procedures are invoked using a call statement, while function procedures do not require a call statement. Second, after a sub-procedure is completed, it does not return any value to the location where it is invoked. However, a function procedure returns a single value to the location where it's invoked. Sub and function procedures can be used to complete the same task in a program. Anything that can be done with a sub-procedure can also be done with a function procedure. As you gain more experience with computer programming, you will find that each procedure is better suited for certain applications. The general syntax for a function procedure is the following. A function procedure begins with function, followed by the name of the function procedure, and parentheses. Arguments may be placed inside the parentheses, and a data type may be specified. If you do not provide a data type, VBA will automatically assign one. The function procedure ends with the end function statement, and inside the function procedure, we can place statements that do various tasks such as perform calculations, display output, or invoke additional procedures. We also have the option of using the exit function statement. The exit function statement terminates the function procedure when executed, and any statements after exit function will not be executed. At some point within the function procedure, the name of the function procedure is assigned a value. This is the value that will be returned to the location where the function procedure originally was invoked. All items shown here with an asterisk are optional, but often are used. Here's an example of how to use a function procedure. When we run this code, three message boxes appear. The first message box states, in funky, 2, 3, -1. The second message box states in funky, -1, 2, 3. And the final message box states 15 and 1. Let's discuss why these values appear in the message boxes. In the subprocedure main, four variables are declared, A, B, C, and D, and these variables are given a double data type. Next, A is assigned the value 2, B is assigned the value 3, and C is assigned the value -1. In the next line, we have D equals funky ABC plus 10. In order to calculate D, we need to know the value of the function procedure funky, which has three arguments, A, B, and C. Notice that we do not use a call statement to invoke funky. We simply state the function procedure's name, as well as its arguments, in the middle of an expression. After the function procedure terminates, a single value will be inserted in the location where funky is invoked. At this point, main will halt and wait for funky to be completed before resuming. Funky is designed to calculate a number with a decimal point, since it is given a double data type. In funky, the arguments A, B, and C are automatically created and given a double data type since the arguments in main, A, B, and C, are also double. The three arguments in main are linked with the three arguments in funky. A in main is linked to A in funky. B in main is linked to B in funky. C in main is linked to C in funky. The initial value of A in Funky is the same value as A in Main, which is 2. The initial value of B in Funky is the value of B in Main, which is 3. And the initial value of C in Funky is the same as the value of C in Main, which is -1. Just like with subprocedures, any changes in the values of A, B, or C in Funky will cause the values of A, B, or C in Main to change after the function procedure is terminated. Inside Funky, a message box appears stating in Funky and the value of A, B, and C, which are 2, 3, and -1. Next, the quantity A times B plus C is calculated, which is 2 times 3 plus -1, or 5, and this value is assigned to Funky. The end function statement terminates the function procedure named Funky, and the values of A, B, and C are passed back up to A, B, and C in Main. In this case, the values of A, B, and C in Main do not change because the values of A, B, and C in Funky were not updated. The value of Funky, which was 5, is returned to Main and replaces the expression Funky A, B, C. 5 plus 10 is 15, and this value is assigned to the variable D in Main. The next line will produce a message box. The message box will state the value of D, which is 15, and then the value of Funky C, A, B. Before the message box can be displayed, we need to calculate the value of Funky C, A, B. The subprocedure Main halts and waits for the function procedure Funky to be completed. Inside Funky, the variables A, B, and C are automatically created and given double data types because C, A, B in Main also are double. The variables C, A, B in Main are linked with A, B, C in Funky. C in Main is linked with A in Funky. A in Main is linked with B in Funky. And B in Main is linked with C in Funky. So A starts off with the value of C in Main, which is -1. B in Funky starts with the value of A in Main, which is 2. And the value of C in Funky starts with the value of B in Main, which is 3. Inside Funky, a message box appears that states in Funky the value of A, B, and C inside Funky, which are -1, 2, and 3. Next, the quantity A times B plus C is calculated, which is -1 times 2 plus 3, which is 1. The value 1 is then assigned to Funky. The end function statement terminates Funky, and the values of A, B, and C are passed back up to C, A, and B in Main. In this case, the values of C, A, and B in Main do not change because the values of A, B, and C in Funky have not been updated. The value of Funky, which is 1, is returned to Main and replaces the expression Funky C, A, B. Now the message box in Main can display the value of D and the value of Funky C, A, B, which are 15 and 1.